patient, for all your contributions. We'll take a break now and entertain questions and answers from the audience. Vivid View.
See and do it.
Vivid View.
My name is Sarah Abechoye. Thank you very much, our guest. My question is this: what is the effort of the government to protect the youth in diaspora? Thank you.
My name is Remba Precious. My question is this: what can the youth in diaspora do in order to involve in the development of the country?
My name is Temi Chokwe, and my question is, what can the government do to encourage our youth abroad back home?
My name is Ubi Aglori, and my question is this: how can the youth get more involved in leadership development of the country?
Vivid View.
Welcome back. The questions have been asked from the audience, so I direct the answer to our guest, Patience.
All right, fantastic questions and brilliant ones. So we'll just take them one after the other. All right, effort of government in protecting youth in diaspora. In terms of protection, I don't think that is only on the government. In my own point of view, even you, the young person yourself, who has found yourself living abroad, the onus is on you, first of all, to be safe. Mm-hmm. So don't engage in activities that will expose you, you know, to danger or even death. I know in recent times there's been reports, you know, in the tabloids and even on the news about young people of Nigerian origin dying in one needless, you know, fight or the other. You should know what took you away from home and took you to those countries. So be focused, do the right things, and don't go where you shouldn't go. Mm-hmm. Don't mingle with bad gangs and all of that. Having said that, the government needs to put things in place, really, so that you don't have a situation where there's a total disconnect, you know, between that person and the country just because the person traveled outside of the country. You are still a Nigerian, and you should be protected by the laws of the land. That's what I think about it. We have ambassadors to virtually every country in the world, you know, and that is their primary role, really. You look out for your own when you're there, you know.
Yes,
protect our people out there. So I think the government has put things in place, really. It's just implementation.
Yes,
exactly. It's not as assertive as you expect it to be. That is why a lot of people think the government isn't doing anything. Really, I think the government has put things in place. It should just do a bit more, you know, so that we don't disconnect from our people when they travel outside of Nigeria.
Thank you. You have spoken well.
All right, the second. All right, the second question is youth in diaspora, how they can be involved in nation building in a number of ways. I said it before, already the fact that you had the opportunity to school outside of Nigeria, means that you've been exposed to endless opportunities. The school, well, unfortunately, but it's the truth, the educational system over there is more organized, more structured than what we have back home in Nigeria, you know, where incessant strike actions will not allow an average young person to concentrate on studies. But over there, you have qualitative education. And what you should do is, after you're done, you bring back innovation back to your country. Be innovative. Like I said, don't believe that because you schooled abroad, so I have to live here all the rest of my life. Home is home. Yeah. And really, there's no place like home. Even though we say Nigeria isn't working. Mm. But trust me, you will live better in Nigeria as a free citizen than where you're abroad, whether they like to admit it or not. There is a racism. You know, even it's still there.
Yeah.
It's still there. There's racism, and you know, but some people will never truly accept you as part of their own because you're black.
Exactly.
You know, so having said that, I'm not trying to promote any kind of racial divide or anything.
No.
You know, even back home we have ethnicity strifes and all of that. But still, you live better as a free citizen when you live in Nigeria. So come back home with what you've garnered over there, and find a way to impact that on the society by being innovative and building bridges, like I said. Build bridges while you're there between Africans of other origin and even non-Africans. Promote the good in Nigeria. Yeah. That is a starting point. Mm-hmm. Identify with your identity, your image as an African. Dress African, speak African is a starting point. Yes, and it, you know, people over there will begin to wonder and they'll become interested, you know, okay, where's this guy from, you know, and where's this girl from, you know. That is a place to start. Open their eyes up to the fact that Nigeria isn't only known for 419 or fraud, as it's been called, or negative things. There are a lot of good products have come out from Nigeria. Chimamanda Adichie is a shining example. Ooh. I mean, she's a Nigerian.
I mean, look.
And she's winning laurels everywhere she goes, you know. So you can be another Chimamanda Adichie by just contributing that little thing you have acquired over there and putting it back into society in Nigeria.
Yeah, that's true. Thank you, Patience, for your contribution so far. But we are still talking or discussing about the question you're answering is talking about what can the areas where youth in diaspora can develop a country if they come. I'm also saying that it's not only in job creation, but it can also help us in environmental issues. You know, sometimes when they come, they eat anything and they put, you know, drop the waste anywhere. And they know they cannot do this where they came from. And when you ask, they say, this Nigeria, the Nigerian factor is Nigeria, so anything goes in Nigeria. Mm-hmm. No, for how long will something like that be going in Nigeria?
So this is an example.
Just as you said before, just a few examples I want to give to add to what we have said. So let's, when they come, they have a lot to do to develop here. If the youths here too are comfortable, I mean, they may not be completely comfortable, you know, in totality, but they are still in our country. So you too can come also and join and do something. And then all of us will work together as a team to develop Nigeria. So next question.
All right, the next question says, what should the government do to encourage youth in diaspora to come back home? This is a big one. All right. First of all, it's not only the government that should encourage this young people to come back home.
Even the parents,
you know. I know that this might not be an easy one on the parents because in the first place, it's because the country is not working. That's why they sent their words abroad and they'll be wondering, okay, you're coming back home to do what? Just stay there and have a good life. But then you should encourage your children to come back home. If they come back home, that's the only time and the only opportunity they will have to impact and
in
to go back into that country. Okay, you, the parents, you live in the country. So it means it's not that bad.
Yes.
You know, bring your children back home. They have gotten the best of education. Mm-hmm. They've been exposed to the best of everything that can obtain in any developed country. When they come back, they can impute that. Mm-hmm. You know, because those ideas are there. They're with them.
Mm-hmm.
And then they come back and be creative with it, about it as well. And then they can make it work in Nigeria here too. Meanwhile, having said that, the government too, they have a fantastic role to play in this in terms of creating an enabling environment. Because really, what those people enjoy abroad is good roads and then electricity. If there is constant power supply, an average Nigerian will have a good life because then businesses will thrive. A lot of business, little business owners cannot make, they can't make profit today because there's no electricity. If there's constant power supply, an average Nigerian will live a good life because then you can, function properly, you can plan, even you can have small businesses that will thrive because your overhead would have been reduced by more than half, you know. And then job creation. I know that the population of unemployed youths today is alarming. And even beyond unemployment is another social ill, which is called underemployment. You find a graduate, you know, at a filling station as a fuel attendant earning 15,000. It's ridiculous.
Yeah.
That's underemployment. It's also a plague on our country.
So
it's not
just
about having a job. It's about what kind of job, you know. So the government needs to look in that direction. Create jobs, you know, for the average youth. If someone can travel abroad, get the best of education, and he or she is assured that when I come back home, you know, I can really get a job, a good job, and function, you know, to the extent of the education that I have gotten, you know, an average Nigerian abroad will always look forward to coming back home.
Yeah. I also want to add to that, when you talk about government to create jobs, I think another way they can do that is to identify some Nigerians, big-time business Nigerians, that have big outfit. And that's, if we support with so-and-so amount of money, how many people can you employ?
Exactly.
You know, if we do that, you know, if they do that, we'll ease unemployment. But they don't remain there because they cannot really create jobs per se for everybody. They have to work with these, you know, with these companies, with these noble private sectors and all. If they can really do that, I think we will create more jobs for our people. So that's the what I want to chip in. Government, please, is something you really need to consider if you have not been thinking about that. So consider that. Look for some big time private sectors and work with them. They will open more ways for labor and for job.
Yeah. All right, the fourth question, which is the last one I have here, is how can the youth be involved in leadership roles in the country? All right. First of all, the youth have their role cut out for them in the sense that they are the building blocks of the society. I mean, in any kind of country you find yourself in, if there are no youths in that country, that society is a dead one.
Yeah.
And fortunately for us, Nigeria, we have a huge youth population. 70% of our population is comprised of the youth.
So, women,
I mean, that means we can have a good economy. Everything should be working in Nigeria. Because the young ones are vibrant. They are full of energy, you know, and all of that. They are raring to go. Their adrenaline is pumping. So I don't see why Nigeria should be in this kind of situation where we are now. But then, having said that, the young person, average young person in Nigeria today isn't concerned or interested in things bordering on politics or that. We are only interested in entertainment.
Because they see it as a dirty game. They see politics as a dirty game and all that.
Beyond that, music, they seem that that's the fastest way to get fame, money, to get money.
Entertainment.
The young one, you the youth, if you're watching me now, you should be interested in things that concern how you are being governed and what is happening in your society. Some young people out there don't even know the name of their state governors. It's as bad as that. And it's because you are not reading. You should be able to read. If you read, it will broaden your mind, broaden your horizon, and then you will see from another perspective on what is going on in your country. And then be engaged in positive things. Politically, you have to be engaged. And I'm not talking about you being a tout or a thug. All these money bag politicians. Be engaged in it. Have a role to play in a positive sense of the word, okay? Even if it's on the word level or, you know, and all of that. Be engaged. Identify with a political party that you agree with what their laid down guidelines and all of that. Yes, you know, you have to go to that. If you don't move from this point to that point, nothing is going to happen. It's not, leadership roles will not be delivered on your laps without you going out and working for it. So I'm saying the young people be more interested in national issues, social issues. It's not just about entertainment is good. I mean, I have no problem with it. But that is not the only thing that will make you a successful person in life. Be interested in other things that will help this country, our dear country called Nigeria. That is one of the ways we can be more interested. And then you need to be innovative. You need to be creative. Sit down on your own. You as a young person, how have you even affected the life of the next door neighbor? You know, somebody, there are people around us who are always in need. As a young person, you have a compassionate spirit. You can start from there. All right, you know, your little 100 naira, 200 naira that you use to play video games and all of that can even do something positive for someone.
Yeah.
So it can help somebody. You can decide to take it from that angle. Let me be more involved in humanitarian causes. It's a good place to start. Nigeria needs a lot of that. We need to help one another to get to where we want to get to.
Thank you so much, Pat, for the answers given. I believe the audience are satisfied with the answers we provided to these questions that are being asked. Yeah, that's true. Youth need to help themselves and be interested in what is going on around you, in your country particularly, so I can post with it. I know sometimes too, the elderly ones in the politics will think that youth, because they're youthful, exuberant, that they don't have experience, they cannot do anything. But if you don't give them chance to do something, how can they have the experience? So you need to give youth chance. We treated it here, we talk about youth involvement and women involvement in politics. We talked about it here extensively. And so if you don't give them chance, how would they be experienced? So let our fathers and our mothers in government, please create an avenue for these youths to really perform. And you will see that they are really intelligent. They are blessed. They have things upset. Yeah. Yes, with those in diaspora and even the ones here in our country. So that's my... So. We are running up now. We ask our final words from our guest.
All right. On a final note, I would like to just deliver this as a word of advice to the young people. Whether you live in Nigeria or outside of it, you are still of Nigerian origin, which makes you a bona fide citizen of Nigeria.
That's it.
It means that you do have a responsibility, a civic responsibility towards this country called Nigeria. Don't always wait for what the government will do for you. You know, there's a popular saying that it's not about what the government will do for you, but what you can do
for your country.
Also for your country and all of that. So you need to look inwards, all right? Don't be carried away by material things, flimsy things, vanity, you know, but be more interested in concrete things, things that will affect lives in a positive way, and let your drive be channeled in that direction. Also, be empowered. As a young person, you need to be empowered. And I'm talking in terms of skill acquisition. Tap into every opportunity that comes your way. I'm here. A TV personality, but trust me, I do so many other things. I'm into fashion designing. I make bags. I make shoes with local fabrics, you know, and all of that. I make beads. I make so many things. Mm-hmm. Because you need to come from every angle for you to be a whole human being. Mm. God has put so many things into one individual. So you need to tap here, tap there. And trust me, it will even make you a fulfilled person at the end of the day. But where you are sitting down and then you are dreaming from day to day, I wish I have 10 million naira now. It's not going to come.
Magic.
If you don't want, you need to hear what some young people say, what they dream about.
It's so high, but you have to do some stuff somewhere.
You have to work. Hard work does not kill. I'm
not
yet
all.
to hear of someone who has succeeded today without hard work. I mean, the Dangotes of this world will tell you how they started from humble beginnings. And that's another thing. You don't always have to start from the top. Start with the little you have, and then but be focused. And you'll be amazing years down the line how far you would have gone with that dream. And most importantly, don't ever give up on this country, Nigeria. It's the best country in the
world. That's it.
VividView.
By way of conclusion, I would say youths in diaspora, and even our youths here too, we have said a lot of things here. We mentioned a lot of things in our discussion. What you can do to also affect your nation, please do so. When you are done with your studies, we join our hearts to say, come back to Nigeria. There's see hope, there's prospect in Nigeria. Even though other things are going on, but come and be a part of it to develop it. We have been 55 years now of independence, and we are still saying developing country. How long do we remain before we develop? But when you finish your studies and you remain where you are, gain employment and start working, you're also developing a country that has already been developed. So please try and come back home after your studies. And I know that God has kept those of us here, will also keep you when you come back. After having said this, I want to invite Pastor Dolly for a presentation to our guests, thanking our patience again for having time to be with us in the studio. And many thanks too goes to the crew, the production crew, the audience here, and our viewers at home. And of course, I will not forget to thank the sponsors of this program, TDS, Services Limited, Orange Insurance Insurance Brokers, and also Orange Printing Press. Thank you for always being there with us. Keep watching Vivid View, same time, same station. Vivid View.
Say and do it.
Vivid View.
Voice when I cry, Lord, I cry.